Today, how to confidently MC or host an event. Now, if you are asked to host an event, you will quickly learn that there is a big difference between preparing a speech or a keynote and being asked to be the MC or host of an event, whether it's a speaking event or a wedding or whatever. There's a big difference. I learned this the hard way by not following the 7 steps you're going to pick up. What I did was I walked into a hosting event and I didn't follow these 7 steps and I just was lost. As a speaker, I have a lot of confidence. As an MC, I realized there are steps you need to take to prepare yourself to be able to host an event with confidence and be called upon to speak and host again. Here they are. Tip number 1, know your agenda. Before you go into any event, get the person that's putting the event together, that's coordinating everyone, to give you a map out of what's going to happen, what's to be expected at what time. You should have a call sheet that tells you how long everything should take, what's coming up next, an overview to follow, because the worst thing you can do is go in to an event not knowing what is supposed to happen when. Secondly, self-talk. Self-talk, self-talk, self-talk. Pump yourself up before you go into the event. You want to have your energy high. Whether you feel confident or not, you want to pump yourself up so you are operating at a level 10 by the time you walk into the event. Nobody cares about the day you've had or that your energy may be low. You need to bring high energy into your event because you are the star. You're the MC and you're making other people the stars as you introduce them. So you want to make sure your energy is high. What I do is I'll play music and I'll pump myself up. I'll say, I'm ready to go. I'm ready to speak. Let's go. I'm going to have a fun night. Whatever it takes to get my energy up so that by the time I walk into the venue, I'm at a 10 and I'm ready to go. Next step is your opening. You need to plan, script, and memorize the beginning of your MC event. What you say right in the beginning needs to be crisp, needs to be sharp, because if you fumble on that, you and your crowd will lose confidence, and it really sets the tone that you are not quite sure what to do next. So make sure the first words out of your mouth are scripted, they're sharp, they're ready to go. Use what I call the 3C method to get some ideas of what you should put in that beginning. First, crowd interaction. Don't let the first words out of your mouth be when they hand you the microphone. Mix with the crowd, get to know them, get to give them a sense of who you are and make them friends. So when you get on stage, you're not uptight and you are loose, ready to speak. Next, comments. Are there any comments that people mentioned, other speakers, that you can bring in and add a sense of freshness to your opening, to your introduction? Ask yourself, is there something that I can bring in to make it current and fresh? And the last C is current. Current events. Is there something going on in news, in politics, in the world that you can bring into your opening to once again make it a fresh beginning, a fresh start to your MC night? Tip number 4 is when you introduce someone. When you're introducing someone at the event, whether it's another speaker, the groom, the bride, best man, whoever it is, whatever your event is, when you're introducing someone, try to know at least one fact about them that you can repeat, that it's okay for you to repeat, so that they feel comfortable when you do repeat it. If you take the time to just research the person that you are introducing, it shows that you took the time to know your crowd, not just be the robotic MC that just reads off a paper, but you got to know the person, and it adds a personal connection to your role as host of the event. Next, number 5 is your downtime. That time in between when you're not introducing someone, when you are not involved. Follow the ABC rule when you're in your downtime. Always be communicating. Mix with the crowd. Get to know people. If you are hosting an event, you are expected to be social for the whole night. As an introvert myself, sometimes I find this hard, but I push myself out there to communicate and really be social even when I'm in my quote unquote downtime as a host. Next, step six is audience interaction. The best way to keep the energy high in yourself and in the whole room as a host is to follow what I call the 3A rule. A number one is ask a question. Asking your audience questions is like being the captain of a team, getting your players involved, getting everyone involved to let them be heard. Your audience wants to be heard, so ask them questions and let them pipe up as well too. You may be the MC or the host, but make people in your audience the stars. Next, activity. Can you get them just to stand up, to participate in some way so that your energy's high and when you move, I think it was Tony Robbins that said, emotions are created by motion. So when people move, they get going, their energy's high, and it makes it an experience for your crowd, not just you emceeing at the front of the room. And finally, audio. Can you turn on some music? Can you get that energy up? Music in any environment raises the energy. So if you have the opportunity, even if you're hosting an event and you need to bring the audio in, bring in some music if it's appropriate and if you've passed it by the people that brought you in first. Bring in music or have music playing if you're at a wedding or if you're hosting an event where there is audio, because that gets the energy up. So if there's a way for you to add audio in, go ahead and do it. And finally, step number seven, closing up. Nothing's better when you close an event than to leave them with some inspiration, whether it's a quote or a short story. And I'll add light inspiration. You don't want to end your hosting of an event talking about how someone in your family passed away and that inspired you to be a better person. No. You just want to leave them on a high, feeling good with maybe an inspirational quote, even a funny / inspirational story, something that you plan again, just like your opening, plan your closing as well so that they know that you are closing strong, then you let them go on a high. Use these seven tips. If you found it helpful, comment below, tell me what you think, subscribe to the channel, and share this on all your social media. I'll see you online. Speak, share, and serve. And remember, if you got value from this video, go right down below the video, click here to subscribe.